Lady Boys Final will be contested between the Central Coast and the Northern Beaches. Central Coast team, number 3 is Jake Herring, number 4, Taimana Ellers, number 16, Dylan Kesby, number 7 is Jesse Walker, 9, Riley Post, number 11, Kynan Hudson, number 21 is Charlie Walkerton, number 23, Travis Jackson, 24 is Riley Jones, 30, Logan O'Brien, 34, Riley Burke, 63, Liam Buckley, and number 80, Isaac Truscott Jones. Their opponents, Northern Beaches. Number 1, Archie Sergi. Number 2, Evan Flynn. Number 3, Nikos De Jesus. Number 4, Tylan Blackberryman. Number 5, Max Dalby Ball Faithful. Number 7, Oliver Baum. Number 8, Tomoko Berryman Duff. Number 9, Ben Cooper. Number 10, Charlie Boyle. Number 11 is Isaac Fotu Moala. Number 12 is Archie Erland. Number 13, Zane Monahan. Number 14, Joel Cooper. And number 16, Nash Ritchie.
Well, here we are, the culmination of 3 brilliant days of touch footballing action in beautiful Dubbo, a battle for the beaches. The Central Coast Dolphins taking on the Northern Beaches Renegades in the 18 Boys Grand Final. James Preston and touch footballing legend Jason Stanton to bring you all the action 25 minutes away from glory. No halftime breaks. The two sides will be changing ends when a try is scored. And, of course, that first try can be absolutely crucial. It's worth 3 points. And, really, the cream has risen to the top here.
This is an absolute huge game, James. I normally sit down in the commentary box, but I'm standing up for this one because I'm so excited to see what our young men can provide us here. Just quickly for the viewers at home, Central Coast did beat Northern Beaches 4-2 earlier in the tournament. So this is a rematch, and Renegades will be coming in hungry.
Well, the Renegades looking for revenge, but here are the Central Coast Dolphins looking for the first try. Big dummy and then a late popped pass. No opening on that occasion, though. They go back to the 7-metre mark. Here's Burke. Burke pops it back towards the middle. Nowhere to go just yet, though, for the Dolphins. They swing to the open side, a passive play out the back. Play on for now for the Central Coast. Still cycling the ball, but that will be a touch pass. In fact, they haven't called it. Play on is the call now, but I think he has put a foot on the sideline in the process of trying to score. Yes, there is the call. And that will be the turnover here in favour of the Renegades. So here come the Renegades now up over the halfway line into enemy territory, rolling forward quite quickly on this occasion. The touch is made. Last play now. Here come the Renegades looking for that all-important first try. There's players in support.
Wow.
Diving forward and getting it. Oh, the Renegades are on the board here. It's a big play from the Northern Beaches.
That was very, very clever from the Renegades. And you've got to have a quick shout-out to their coaching staff, Harry Berryman, Nathan Wong. Earlier in the tournament, they were playing quite static, slowing it up, running quick release type plays. They've come into the grand final, James. They've made a correction, and they're running at them, a bit like rugby league style on the back of the drive. Central Coast weren't expecting it. A great correction from the Renegades.
And Blackberryman is the try scorer, the first of the match. 3-0 here in favour of the Northern Beaches Renegades. Of course, the previous match, it was the Dolphins who claimed victory, so they strike early here, the Sydney Siders. So now they work through the middle, but no scoring play there for the Dolphins. And just a little correction here as well. We do have Tyler Blackberryman on the sheet itself, but I've been told he's going with just the name of Berryman for this particular tournament. As the Northern Beaches Renegades work upfield once again here. Running at pace. A couple of dummies coming in play.
Yeah, really, really clever there on that play. Tylan Berryman, how when the scooper got into the in goal, he didn't panic. He actually went a bit infield, if you have a look on the replay, and then he changed his line and ran back towards the bottom of your screen and got himself separate, or, you know, got that separation from the defender. So that was very experienced play there from Tylan Berryman.
So they'll try and restart things here through Trusker Jones in the 80 for the Central Coast Dolphins. Good metres here from Isaac Trusker Jones. Now followed up here with Burke, slow but purposeful in his approach. Plays it on the 7. In fact, no touch. Now he finally does get that attention from the Renegades defensive line. Once more drops it on the 7. Burke stopping on a dime, twisting, trying to find an opening. Nothing presenting itself just as of yet here against a resolute Renegades defensive line. They feign the wraparound out to Trusker Jones. Trusker Jones with a flick pass nearly came off for them. The Dolphins already looking to try something a little creative.
Yeah, and hopefully their coach doesn't mind me saying they're running alternate plays here. So we've watched enough of this Central Coast outfit. You know, they are the number one team here or coming in as favourites. I think I've got most of their attacking moves down pat, and they're definitely running the alternates of their play. So what I mean by that, instead of maybe attacking the left on a sweeping play, they're actually going the right. Instead of bouncing out, they're bouncing in. So that's not all that bad to start the game with that, but at some point, I think Mitch is going to make that change, and they're going to move back to their more traditional plays, which upset Renegades earlier in the tournament.
So Kesby ruled to go back onto the mark and play this one, with the changeover occurring. Referee saying that loose ball was not as a result of any pressure applied from the Dolphins defenders. Play on again is the call here as Kesby comes forward, picks up good metres. And now they get up over halfway pretty easily here. Travis Jackson, short ball here to O'Brien. O'Brien, it's gone behind them. So the Dolphins just feeling a little bit of pressure here early on.
Yeah, a little bit uncharacteristic from the Dolphins. Like, they're a really classy outfit, the Dolphins, and I'm sure they'll settle into the game. I think they've tried a few things a bit different, maybe a little bit flustered because the Renegades have actually come out and, you know, taken the game to them a bit. But there's still 20 minutes left, plenty of time, and they'll just settle in, and I think we'll see the best of Dolphins in the next 20 minutes.
Renegades here on the last play. They scoop it up and go. Berryman Duff popping it back on the inside. Here is Berryman himself now. Nearly got away for them, but they'll get another set to work with here. They said he was offside, particularly Liam Buckley.
Yeah, I think that was Sanderson, and I really liked seeing that sort of early call from the referee because it gives the attack a chance to have a crack, and then he's come back for the penalty. So Sanderson, good sort of comms to the defender early to let him know they're offside. So really impressive there.
Play on again is the call here. Sanderson saying that both sides were at fault in that particular play of the ball. Nice little dummy there from Charlie Boyle running at pace. Didn't fool either of the defenders though. Both of them were waiting for him. So around about 6 minutes gone in this grand final here. The 18 boys division. Central Coast Dolphins managed to get the win against the Renegades last night 4-2, but they find themselves behind the eight ball here. They'll play it on the 7. Berryman Duff, short ball. Great ball for that matter. They just get there in time though, the Dolphins. And they'll come back to the 7-metre mark here.
Great scramble.
Not done with just yet though.
Yeah, great scramble there. Tomoko running that play. Let's see what Tylan has on this one. That was the 6. Tylan not trying to sort of say there was one more to go, but I've been impressed with the way that the Renegades have started the game. It doesn't mean like the game's over, but they've actually come out with an alternate game plan. They're doing stuff a bit different. You'll notice Tylan hasn't really run any statics yet. Like, he hasn't done any little dive overs yet. They're doing dump scoop. So they're playing a different style, and that's really clever from Berryman and Wong on the Renegades coaching staff. And Mitch has probably already picked up on that, and he'll be making adjustments now.
Of course, Mitch Walkinen, who's been joining us in commentary throughout the 3 days, coaching the Central Coast Dolphins 18 boys side here in this grand final. Nice little dummy, but shut down in defence there from the Renegades. And the extra set of 6 here is as a result of that forceful touch on O'Brien as he was heading towards the subs box area. Buckley plays it. And they get another penalty. They'll have to be careful here, of course. If you're new to the game, 3 penalties inside that 7-metre mark and on the try line against the defensive side results in a player being sat down. Quick hands here for Walkerton. Charlie Walkerton plays it. Burke again threatening to link up. Berryman does a good job to shut things down. They're really up for this one, the Renegades. They play it quickly, walking him back to the middle, getting to ground quickly, but a great touch coming across in the end there from Nash Ritchie. They'll pop it off once again here. Burke slumming things down. Through the centre come the Dolphins. They get the strike done. Burke, long ball. They've marked up well, though. They'll pop the pass back towards the middle, and the pressure mounts there from the Renegades.
Yeah, that was good, but I like seeing that sort of variety in attack from the Dolphins. And one of the things I think it's important to point out to those at home is that a lot of these players, like, they're watching the stream on Bar TV. They're going back, doing their homework, watching the, you know, the previous games, and they all sort of are quite familiar with the moves that have been run. So it's not just enough to run your standard plays. You've got to have change-ups. You've got to execute perfectly. And that's something that's sort of, you know, coming into the modern game now.
Well, here is the Renegades working very quickly out of acting half. Flynn was trying to put down the foot and open up some space. This one going along very quickly. Nearly 9 minutes of play has transpired already. 3-0. With the one try here in favour of the Northern Beaches Renegades. How important will that first try turn out to be? The Dolphins yet to get on the board here as they promote the footy pretty quickly. Buckley in an acting half. Now picks it up with a one-handed scoot and goes for it himself. But a great saving touch there from Archie Sergi.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind seeing Buckley and Walker maybe get the ball in their hands a bit more. They definitely look dangerous for the Dolphins and probably haven't had as much ball in this first 10 minutes. So hopefully they can gravitate to that to the ball a bit more in the next 10 minutes and oh sorry 10 next 15 minutes and really ask some questions of this Renegades defense.
So another set to play with here for the Renegades in good field position too. They start on the halfway line. Touches made there. Play number one. Berryman now up through the middle as Berryman Duff picks up the ball here. Berryman drops it off to Berryman Duff. Here is Berryman now. It's a berry-a-thon. Back to the seven they go.
Yeah, Tomoko and Tyler, I wouldn't mind them. I actually think they're a good chance going static now. They're going a bit wide now. I think probably an inside dive play might actually work.
Well, here is Berryman deciding against that particular play. I think it's out of the hands backwards. The referees like it. It's a beautiful ball there for Berryman. And they do collect their second try of the match. The Northern Beaches 5-0.
That was superb. I don't mind getting proven wrong on that occasion, but what was even better than me getting proven wrong was they've actually thrown the ball into that gusting wind corner, which we've seen so many teams not been able to do throughout the finals day. So a really good ripping pass into the wind, found the mark, and there's a bit of a hill now to climb for the Central Coast Dolphins. They're down 2-0.
Certainly is the case on the ISC apparel scoreboard. 5-0, 2 tries for the Dolphins looking to get there first. Now they're claiming the touch here. I think he did make it in time. Certainly, Monaghan thinks he did. The referees disagree, and the Central Coast Dolphins are on the board. 5-2 is the score.
Yeah, and I don't think the Renegades did a lot wrong. It was just a really crisp pass, a really nice put down, and it was nice to see referee Cooper and Wake, they're right on the spot with a quick call. That was down first. Give the try, back to halfway, keep the action happening.
So the margin reduced, back to 3, as if nothing happened in the last 2 minutes. Here comes Berryman Duff. Short ball here for Berryman. Up to that 7-metre mark, gets the strike dump. Berryman again, threatening to go long. Long pass indeed. Finds the winger. They marked up well, though, the Dolphins. The assignment not done with yet. They still have a few plays to contend with. Berryman pops it down. Berryman Duff with the footwork, popping the pass. It's kept alive here, basketball style. Berryman with the world's biggest goose step. Denon Kemp would love that. Play on is the call. They switch it back to the middle. Oh, great saving touch there in the end. The Dolphins all over it.
Yeah, really good defense there from the Dolphins. And maybe Renegades a little bit, you know, maybe too adventurous on that set. Probably would have been good to use their set and finish up on the trial line rather than the Dolphins now. Charging over halfway. That's only the second touch. This is a great platform for the Dolphins.
Kesby working well out of acting half here. Supplies it for Walker. One of the two players you've said needs to really stamp his authority on this game. He tries to do exactly that with a ball here to Kesby. How about the pass from Walker? They kept the width. They've got their second, the Central Coast Dolphins.
Sharp play. Great to see Walker with the ball in his hands. He's dangerous every time he touches it. I'm not too sure why it took 10 minutes for Central Coast to give him the pill, because he's absolutely outstanding. And again, we've seen those two referees again, Cooper and Wake, right on the spot. The reason I'm sort of, you know, giving a bit of a shout out there is they could easily be called a touch if the referees are not in great position. But because they're there right on the spot, Central Coast are benefiting from, you know, some really good calls, as in, like, you know, the correct calls.
So 5-4 on the scoreboard, thanks to Dubbo Council. As the pass is provided here, short, Berryman back to Berryman Duff through the middle. Once more threatening with the dancing footwork like Fred Astaire. Berryman follows up in like kind. Play on now for the Renegades. Berryman Duff firing it long. They scrambled really nicely there. It was Riley Jones who came across and shut it down. But no advantage here for the Northern Beaches Renegades. They'll get another set to play with close to the line.
Yeah, Sanderson, the referee, they're calling that the Dolphins players have to be moving up. So it's a bit of a handful for the defence. They've got to move up. Then on the touch, they've got to hit the line. It's hard work. That bobbled, I think.
Certainly did. And once more, our referees are on the spot, having a good match in this grand final. And certainly so are both of our competitors here. The two teams really putting on a show. Couple of big dummies there from Burke. Burke's away. It's a foot race between him and Berryman. Burke puts the foot down. Oh, Berryman with the try-saving touch. It's all happening here at Dubbo. Back to the seven they go. Burke passing it away here for Herring. Herring to the middle. Oh, big touch coming in. More than big. It's forceful. They'll get another set to work with here.
Yeah, this is two scores each. This game's in the balance, and this is what we saw earlier with the way Central Coast, you know, played against Manly, where they just stuck in the game, stayed with it, and then they just slowly grinded over the top of their opposition. We're seeing it again here now. Central Coast really working their way into the game. That's two penalties. This is pressure now for Renegades. This is about as much pressure as you're going to get. Grand final, the score locked up in terms of tries and two penalties against you.
Of course, one more. We'll see a Renegades player forced over to the sideline. Oh, I tell you what, I think there was no attempt to use the hands there at all. Unfortunately for Oliver Baum, the captain, who does not lead by example on that occasion, I think he's going to be forced subbed. Yeah, there we go. In fact, he's marched all the way up the other end. So just go through the difference here for us, Jason, about forced sub compared to being pushed up the other end. What is the actual equation for the defensive line?
Yeah, well, force sub, you just get that replacement, so he's still 6-on-6. When a player gets sin bin or sent up the other end, now it's 6-on-5. Central Coast with a one-player overlap for two full sets of like possessions each.
So it's a long time to deal with. And straight away, the Dolphins make them pay. It's not worth it from Baum, but it certainly is the result they are wanting. I think Jesse Walker this time is the recipient, having already acted as the man pulling the strings. The Central Coast Dolphins hit the lead 6-5.
And it isn't any coincidence at all that Renegades were controlling the pace of this game, and then Central Coast made some changes through Coach Walker, and then Walker injected himself into the game. You know, long ball try, short ball to Walker try, that's no coincidence. He's in the game. Central Coast playing a bit more like a higher intensity, and now Renegades are up against it.
DeJesus is out there now in the three for them. Black Berryman and Berryman Duff operating through the middle. Berryman has a crack himself. Tries to bury under them, but they have got him in time inside the final 9 minutes here. So Berryman Duff waits at acting half. They've got one more play in this set. You can cut the tension with a knife here. Nobody leaving early. A really good crowd on hand to watch this one too. The grandstand on both sides of us here in the commentary booth is full, Jason.
Yeah, the crowd really enjoying it, and it's a great exhibition of touch. You couldn't be mistaken of thinking it's like a State of Origin or a Men's Open game. Like, the skill from both teams and the speed of play, flying up and down the field. Three or four touches are up over halfway. This is great footy from both teams.
Nice run there. Pick up plenty of meterage. And now they work it away through Buckley. Buckley sees some open space and puts the foot down. Now turning it back on the inside. Still life here for the Dolphins. Oh, if they could have gotten it away one final time, they'd open them up once more on this commentary side of the ground. But good scramble from the Renegades as Berryman hops in at acting half, and they keep operating down a short side. Close to their subs box, they get reinforcements now. Flynn comes forward and plays it on halfway. Berryman Duff into enemy territory. Here he is again on the follow-up. A nice drive from Berryman Duff. Last play, gets the strike dump. Here comes Flynn. Oh, Buckley does a good job and stops him.
Yeah, the number was probably on the other side. And And this game's almost like you could break it into like three thirds essentially. The first part of the game was dominated by the Renegades with their initial game plan. Then the Central Coast adjusted, came back, dominated the middle part, and now we're into the last part of the game, and it's still, you know, on a knife's edge.
Here's O'Brien as they flick it away, trying to keep the ball alive. It hasn't arrived into the hands, though, of Riley Jones, waiting wide out there. So they'll get let off the hook on this occasion here, the Renegades.
Yeah, player back on now, 6-on-6. And I just wanted to highlight that when we're talking about the players knowing the other moves, like someone might say, what do you mean they know the moves? It's not, they don't know the names of the moves, but they watch the games and they see how the tries are scored. And I was chatting earlier today to the Catalano brothers, two of the up-and-coming stars that played in the Southern. JP played in the Southern last week. Junior's a bit older, but they were saying, oh, Thailand's going to run this and Walker's going to run that. And that's sort of like the modern game now. They all know each other.
I certainly get a good chance to check out all the action with the amount of coverage that we do provide here for New South Wales Touch Football. Courtesy of Bar TV, you've done a great job bringing the production to you so far for this tournament. Last game of an epic 3 days here at Dubbo. Thanks to Dubbo Council as it comes wide here to Jones. Jones up towards the halfway line, running at potentially an offside player for a moment before they retreated the required distance. They pick it up once more through Jones, and the run continues forward. Last play now, Burke, short ball, flick pass comes out, just left behind. Once more, enterprising play here from the Dolphins.
Yeah, I've noticed, Renegades handled that really well. I've noticed the Renegades, a couple of their senior players probably staying on a little bit longer in their sets. That's not necessarily a bad thing, but it does sort of, you know, take a bit of the edge off if you stay on too long. So this is going to be interesting, this last 5 minutes. I think Central Coast have got the run of the game. Renegades are going to have to pull something out of the bag, I think.
So Renegades behind on the scoreline here, only by the one play, but I'd almost say next try scorer wins here. That's been touched in flight. It ends up in the hands of the Dolphins. So I think we'll see another set here. Yes, it's ruled as such from Sanderson. Good call from the man in charge.
Yeah.
Five on the clock.
This is probably their best chance, James. Renegades, I think they've lost a bit of their run through the midfield. This is going to be their chance to try and take the grand final. I don't know whether they'll have many better opportunities in the last 5 minutes in here. Six touches. Let's see what they can muster up.
So a full complement of players, of course, with Baum back into the action. He's out there at the moment, threatening to connect here with Berryman. Receives it now, Baum, and they get the strike dump. Here he comes. Berryman having a crack himself. Berryman has got that to ground for all money. It's try time. It's his second of the match, and they are back in front.
Great try there by Tylan Berryman. That's what I was trying to allude to earlier, but I think I went off about 8 minutes too early, James. I felt like that direct dive on the inside, you know, like between the two middles was where I was starting to see a bit of space there. And Tylan Berryman, he knows his way to the try line. If you just give him a sniff, it's a try. And now Northern Beaches with the edging in front because of that first try. I think it's three tries all, is that right?
It's just the first try. Three tries apiece. So 7-6. With that crucial first try, giving the extra point here to the Northern Beaches Renegades, which now means all the pressure falls back onto the Dolphins. They did have the momentum well and truly in their favour for a bit of time there. So they pop it back towards the middle now. O'Brien, Burke threatening to link up out wide. O'Brien comes short to walk it in. Big ball here from O'Brien. They've completely stripped them for numbers. Riley Jones is on the spot. He goes in for them. And now 4-3 in terms of the try scored. It means the Central Coast Dolphins are back in the lead.
Yeah, I can't wrap that high enough. That is pure, absolute brains from the Central Coast. They've run that play probably 25 times over the course of the weekend. No one's seen that little step off, like a little two-step off option off it. I'll come back to that later if I get a chance, but absolute clever play. They've just brained them on that occasion.
So Berryman Duff supplying short, and they play it inside the seven. What a ball. That is straight away they go, but they haven't got there in time. Jones had the cover. I think the ball was knocked on anyway. So inside the final three, and both sides throwing everything, including the kitchen sink, at each other. Someone call a plumber. Jones up the sideline now. Good speed shown from Riley. He plays it just shy of the halfway line. Oh, surely there was a knock on there. They've gotten away with one, the Dolphins, though.
Yeah, maybe a little bit lucky for the Dolphins. And this is where they can come down, maybe get a repeat set or a penalty, and really ice this grand final. It's all up to them now. I don't know. whether Renegades can win it unless Central Coast open up the opportunity for them. Couple minutes to go. Let's see if they can stay nice and composed.
So here they come again. The Dolphins up towards that 7 metre mark. Burke plotting and probing. Walkerton's there, but they're also on the spot. Berryman makes the touch. Last play now. Just one more to contend with here for the Renegades defensive line. They can't afford to concede. They would know that themselves, the Dolphins, but they can't conjure up anything here as Burke returns the footy, and they've got just under 2 minutes now to pull this one out of the fire. They'll get one full set here, maybe a couple of plays right at the death after that. They head up towards halfway. The touch is made now from Travis Jackson. Ball away from Baum. Baum back to the middle. They've got to drive hard and straight here. They can't afford to be stopping on the run. Now Berryman Duff gets them in the right direction. And the strike dump. Here comes Berryman. This is the play. How about the footwork from Berryman? Berryman Duff for the corner. Oh, they're in. You're joking. They've stolen it with Zane Monaghan. What about the play from the Northern Beaches Renegades?
And that was out of nothing, James. I did not see that coming. I was getting ready to circle Central Coast as the champs. They still might be the champs, but the Renegades are going to make them earn it with only a minute to go.
What a grand final it's turning out to be here. I told you we saved you the best for last. It's certainly been the case. Here come the Central Coast Dolphins. One final attempt at the line here. The Renegades, the job is simple. Just mark up and make the touch. O'Brien, short ball, Buckley, Jones, quick hands. They mark up again. Midway through the count, back to the seven they go. O'Brien is there, waiting for it. He hops in at acting half now. Last play, O'Brien, quick hands. They've got them for number one. They make the touch. Berryman knows he's got it. And I think the Renegades have got it now. 30 seconds on the clock. They just have to hold the ball.
Tylan Berryman, we've been wrapping his attack. We've been wrapping his quickies and his dives. How about the defence? How about the defence, James? That's won the grand final from a pure effort play, scrambling along the try line when they've got an overlap and pretty much diving. Like, sensational by Berryman.
And silly play here from the Dolphins, giving away a penalty. Man forced from the field. 2 seconds on the clock. They're coming up quickly here to try and close it down. Walkerton. Berryman has got no interest in continuing things. There is the siren. They just need to make the touch. They put it to ground. It's it. Berryman, the hero here for the Northern Beaches Renegades. 9-8, they've claimed it. And Jason Stanton, I don't think I even need to ask you who your Guzman and Gomez player of the match is. I'm sure the initials are TB.
Yes, you have got the player of the match, but I do want to add the reason why he's player of the match, because I actually think that for the most part of that game, I'm trying to get his first name now. Tomoko Berryman, was it? From the Northern Beaches, the number eight. I thought Berryman Duff really controlled the game and had really good touches. But what I loved about Tylan Berryman was after putting on a couple explosive plays that got us excited, he actually played the last 5 or 6 minutes of that match, drove well, defended well, and that dive down there in the bottom right of your screen pretty much won them the grand final. So, yes, the player of the match is Tylan Berryman, but I'd like to give him a bit of encouragement that it was due to his defence, not so much his attack.
Well, both you and I went up here in the booth when he made that touch, and then certainly with the follow-up play to claim it here for the Northern Beaches. One of the great matches in the 18 boys division for New South Wales touch football, in any competition for that matter. What a game at full time. The Northern Beaches 9-8, and that does wrap us up here for the tournament. We hope you've enjoyed all the action across Friday, Saturday and Sunday. I'd just like to give a massive thank you to all of the commentary partners in the booth here. Jason Stanton, yourself included, Mitch Walkerton, David Stone, Deacon Cameron also hopping in, and Nathan Loveday doing a great job, Jordan Parsonage as well, and everybody else who has helped out across the 3 days. And also a massive thank you to the Dubbo Council, Guzman and Gomez, Hyperactive Merchandising, ISC official apparel partner, Budgie Smugglers, and of course Bar TV, Josh and the team. But from all of us here at New South Wales Touch Football, what a way to finish it up. We've enjoyed your company, and we'll see you for all the conference finals next week at Tempe. That is full time here at Dubbo.
If we have all of the teams that just competed in the 18 boys and girls grand finals making your way over to the presentation area.